Hey guys, this is Steve Huff from stevehuffphoto.com. Today I'm going to bring you an audio review, a HiFI review of a 300B and 845 tube amplifier, Class A, 24 watts per channel. I reviewed it on stevehuffphoto.com 4 years ago, the written review. When I reviewed it 4 years ago, it was probably my favorite integrated amp of all time. And 4 years later, it's still my favorite integrated amp of all time. If you guys know me, you know I'm also a hi-fi buff, a camera buff, and I love hi-fi just as much as photography. So I've reviewed a lot of hi-fi gear at stevehuffphoto.com. If you want to see it, you go over there, go to the menu, click reviews, and then scroll down to the hi-fi section. I recently reviewed the Klipsch Heresy III speakers that I'll be playing with this, but I want to show you guys this amazing amp. Now, this is not some crazy $100,000 system. It's not a $50,000 system. It's not a $20,000 system. I actually got this amp at a great buy, used, at my local dealer, Arizona HiFi in Phoenix, Arizona. The speakers are pretty affordable in the grand scheme of things when you're talking HiFi. There are speakers that go up to the $100,000, $200,000 mark, but it's not uncommon to see speakers for $20,000, $30,000 in the HiFi realm. So these Klipsch Heresy III speakers are $2,000 a pair, so they're affordable for HiFi and they sound lovely with this 24 watt per channel Class A integrated amp, the Line Magnetic 219IA. Let's take a look video-wise 4 years after my written review.
Welcome guys to a HiFi audio review. This is for the Line Magnetic 219IA integrated amplifier. This amplifier is 24 watts per channel of Class A tube magic. This thing is a dual mono design, so as close as you're going to get to mono blocks. It uses 845 and 300B tubes and will power almost any speaker. This thing sounds sublime.
Carve me open love and show me all the things you want, 'cause I'm going ba-da, ba-ba-da.
So I'm gonna play a couple of quick samples. This video is not monetized because I'm using music, but I want to give you guys a couple of examples of instruments, voices, even some rock music. This system sounds amazing with digital or vinyl. I'm using as my source here basically a Sonos Connect into a DacMagic 100, and I'm running Spotify Premium through the Sonos wirelessly. So it's basically, I just turn on my phone or my computer, bring up Spotify, it wirelessly sends whatever music I want to listen to. And while not high res, it still sounds beautiful, rich, warm, and fills the room with a huge wall of sound. These Klipsch Heresy speakers, version 3, are quite amazing when you're in a small room. Now my room is around 12 by 12, which should be a nightmare for sound, but usually if I put smaller speakers in this room, they sound amazing. So this amp pairs very well with these Klipsch Heresy 3s, and from what I understand, the other speakers in the Klipsch heritage line.
All right, I'm in my listening chair in the sweet spot, and we are going to put on a collection or different songs. So you can kind of hear a little bit of the quality. Keep in mind, with YouTube, you're never going to be able to hear the accurate reproduction, but you'll get an idea of the sound that this creates. It's very full. It's like a wall of sound. It has great imaging, a huge sound stage, fills my whole room, and you can kind of pick out the instruments. Vocals are always dead center where they should be. This puts the stage a little out front. You feel like you're almost on the stage with the artist in person. But YouTube, with compression and the fact that I'm using just a standard mic here, you're not going to hear them how I hear them. But even so, it can give you an idea.
Awesome.
less than 1 watt here, and it's filling this room. So that is Haunted Laundry with a song called Cheated. Sounds phenomenal in this room through these speakers. The detail in the acoustic instruments is organic. It's never harsh. These speakers are never harsh at all. In fact, they lean more towards the warm side of neutral, but that is also a side effect of that amp, which is just beautiful. Here's a little bit of Tom Waits.
It's dreamy weather, we're on. You waved your crooked wand along an icy pond.
Now, that's using less than 1 watt. You know, when it comes to sound quality, these speakers are so sensitive, it doesn't take much of these 24 watts. Here's one from Flo Morrissey. Here's some beautiful vocals here. Patrick Wilson, The Lighthouse. I just want to say that as I'm listening here, his voice is floating like right here. And I hear the piano kind of over that way and other sounds coming from over that way. It's three-dimensional when you listen to it in person.
So coming in a little blind.
Now, if you're like in here enjoying some wine or a drink and you really get into it with the lights out, it's almost as if you're in the room with the artist. It can be eerie at times with a higher end system. How about something with some instrumental? This amp has some balls, man. I'll tell you that. It's very powerful for the power output. That's because of the dual mono design. It's a dual mono design, so it's like having a pair of mono block amplifiers. Here's Enigma, Amen.
I'm out on a new road in search for a land with no name.
Fast forward a little bit.
It's time to go.
Sounds so good. Let's do one more, some vocals. Fast forward it.
What I really could care for.
Pink Martini.
And then that suddenly appeared before me.
It's using like a quarter of a watt.
Now I'm no longer alone.
So these speakers are pretty amazing, guys, as is the amp. And it's the amp that is going to give you that sound, that richness, those vocals to die for, the space, the air. That Class A tube design works wonders for these speakers, the Klipsch Heritage line. These are the Heresy 3s. The Forte 3s sound delicious as well. And almost any speaker, I've ran this amp with Dyne Audios that are notoriously hard to drive, and they filled this room with the richest sound. Sonus Faber, Gornieri Evolutions, used this amp to drive them. It gave me the best sound from those speakers. So if you are into hi-fi and you're into tube amps, I highly recommend you look into this. Read my review over at stephofoto.com. I'll put the link in the description below. But man, I got like close to 4K off of this amp, buying it used, lightly used. It retails for $7,500. I bought mine from Arizona HiFi in Phoenix. To me, that's my favorite HiFi shop in the whole state of Arizona. There's three or four, but I love Arizona HiFi. It's a great place to go check out. They have turntables, tube amps, and I'm not affiliated with them in any way. I just love what they do over there. So I hope you enjoyed this look at the Line Magnetic 219IA. You can see it has three inputs here. So I have a turntable through a phono stage as well as the Sonos going in. You can turn on and off the backlight. You have your feedback. You can go no negative feedback or max negative feedback. You can put a preamp in and use this as a power amp. This is your biasing meter, so you can bias the tubes, which is very, very easy to do. You have 845s, 300Bs, 310As, and 12AX7s. In the amp, here's your dual transformers. Oh my goodness, this is a beautiful amp, guys. It does put out some heat. These 845 tubes run very hot, so it will warm up your space if you're in a small room. In the summertime here in Phoenix, this amp raises my temperature by 5 to 10 degrees at least. But these speakers are beautiful. I have the grills back here. I like to listen with them off. I'm running some AudioQuest Rocket 44 speaker cable, nothing exotic here. And it sounds great. So thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye. I've been searching for my